Masaya kayong lahat?
Amen.
I need more. I think you didn't understand Tagalog. I need more. Are you all happy, church?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We need to be happy. Let's forget whatever is happening outside.
Amen.
Let's be totally disconnected. Let's forget the stress at job. Let's forget bitterness. Let's forget everything. Like if a friend has not spoken back to you, if your love is not reciprocated, just forget it. Just forget it. It's said in the Bible that two or three gather up together, he's in our midst. So he is right here. Pour out your grievances, pour out your spirits and pray to him with all your heart and with all your soul. God has never left us. He's always been with us. We all know about it. He's also revealed that in the scripture, in Joshua chapter 1, verse 9, have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged.
Amen.
For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
Amen.
So this is your moment. As I told you, shut off yourself from the outside world. Lord is here. Praise him. Worship him. Let's join the worship with our worship leader, Brother Max. And meditation song by Sister Melanie.
Amen.
And opening prayer by Brother Jay.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. We really can feel the joy in the heart of Brother Raj. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Magandang gabi po sa ating Panginoon. Amen. Hallelujah. Sa gabi pong ito, mithin po ng bawat isa na magkaroon po tayo ng puso na maglingkod po sa ating nag-iisang Diyos na buhay. Amen. Praise God.
Unfailing love that's a standing in awe of your grace, setting my feet in your ways, entering into your presence to behold your face to face.
God of all,
God of all heaven and earth,
holding me in your embrace,
holding me in your embrace, unfading love that surrounds me. Oh God, I stand amazed. My Jesus, my Lord, you're the love of my life. Wherever you go, wanna be by your side. You're from the light, but Christ living in me, serving you for all eternity. My eyes set on you in this race that I've run. No longer I'll wait, let your will be done. Make me a servant, my heart self a truth. You are my Lord, I follow you.
Patuloy po nating purihin at sambahin ang ating Diyos. Hallelujah! Hallelujah, Lord! Hallelujah, Lord Jesus! Jesus! Jesus, hallelujah! Aming Ama, nasa langit, Lord, aming makapangyarihang Diyos. Lord God, muli, patuloy po kaming dadalangin sa iyong pinakamakapangyarihang pangalan, Lord God Jesus. Sa gabing ito, Lord God, patuloy kami na magsusumamo sa iyong harapan. Humihingi, Lord God, ng aming kalinisan ng aming puso at isipan, Lord Jesus, dahil nagbatid namin, Lord, na sa aming mga pagkakasala, pagkukulang sa iyo, ay nailalayo mo ang iyong mukha sa amin, Lord God, kung kami ay patuloy na magkakasala, Lord God. Kaya sa lahat po ng aming mga nagawa, naisip, mga bagay na hindi namin nasunod, Lord, na iyong ipinag-uutos, Lord, patuloy po kaming humihingi ng kapatawaran. At nawa, Lord, patuloy na makamtan namin ang iyong awa, ang iyong mercy, Lord God, sa gabing ito, sa buhay namin, upang patuloy kami na lumapit sa iyo sa gabing ito at magpurit. Magpasalamat po, Lord God Jesus. Kaya muli, Lord, tunay na lahat ng bagay sa mundong ito ay sa iyo lamang nanggaling, Lord God. Ang lahat ng kaalaman, wisdom ng tao ay sa iyo nanggaling, Lord God Jesus. Kaya patuloy po namin inilalapit ang aming mga kapatid, ang bawat isa na tatayo sa gabing ito, Lord God Jesus. Nawa, makaptan ng aking mga kapatid, Lord, ang knowledge and wisdom na sa iyo lamang nanggagaling, Lord God. Mula sa aming kapatid sa MC, Lord God, patuloy na ikaw lamang umawak sa kanyang buhay. Bless him, Lord God, lalo na po sa kanyang tahanan, Lord God, na patuloy niyang binubuksan upang magpatuloy po ang gawain po ng iyong mga salita, Lord God Jesus. Maraming salamat po, Lord. Lahat ng aming mga kapatid sa Asari Ministry, lahat ng mga kapatid namin sa tamburin, Lord God, ng mga sumasayo ng mga bata, Lord God, patuloy namin din nadalangin sila, mga kaming mga kapatid sa lahat ng music and ministry, Lord God Jesus, ang kanilang mga kamay ay hipuin mo, Lord God, upang ang lahat ng kanilang tutugtugin ay tunay na magkaroon ng kaayusan, Lord God, dahil ikaw ang aming Diyos ng kaayusan, Lord God Jesus. Maging ang buong music, praise and worship team, Lord God, ang aming song leader, Lord God Jesus, talangin namin na ikaw ang humipo sa kanilang buhay, Lord God. Maging ang aming kapatid na magbibigay ng offertory message, Lord, touch her lips, Lord God. Nawa, Lord God, ang mga salita na kanyang ipararating ay tunay na ito ay sa iyo nanggagaling din, Lord God Jesus. Lord God, lalo-lalo na po ang aming mahal ng kapatid, Lord God, ang aming pastor na iyong gagamitin sa gabing ito na bilang daluyan ng iyong pagpapala ng iyong mga banal na salita. Patuloy naming dalangin na ikaw lamang ang lumukob sa kanya, ang iyong banal na espiritu, Lord God Jesus, na maipahayag niya with power and boldness at aming mapag-unawa ang lahat ng iyong mga salita, Lord God Jesus. Bless His whole family, Lord God Jesus, at ang lahat po ng aming mga workers sa iglesyang ito ay ikaw lamang, Lord God, ang magbigay ng kalakasan sa bawat isa upang kami ay patuloy na lumakad sa iyo, Lord God Jesus. Kaya muli, Lord God, lahat po ng pasasalamat at ang iyong tanging pangalan lamang ang itinataas namin sa iglesyang ito, Lord God, dahil ikaw ang tunay na nag-iisang Diyos, Lord God Jesus. Kaya mula umpisa hanggang matapos po ang gabing ito, ang iyong espiritu ang aming dalangin na manguna sa gabing ito, Lord God. Kaya muli, maraming salamat. Ito po ang aming dalangin sa iyong pangalan, Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Praise. As all of you know that Bible study has started in Jufair. When I came into this faith, I never knew one day there'll be Bible study center in my place as well. So it's a great blessing. And yesterday's 180 degree message that we had discussed, it was so informative because I come from totally a different faith. And I was able to clarify so many things which had taken me deeper into the faith. So I'll request and encourage all of you to recommend this place for non-Filipinos so that it will help them understand the true worth of one living God that we all follow. We have visitors, Brother Aljo, husband of Sister Charlotte. Welcome, Po. Welcome again, Sis Charlotte. Amen. Welcome online viewers. Good evening, good morning, good afternoon. We have Sis Jane from Bahrain, Sis Scarlett from Philippines, Brother Jayam Adalave and family, Sister Irish, Bahrain, Brother Mark Morillo, Philippines, Sis Nadine, Bahrain, Brother Hervey and family, Oman, Sister Grace, Bahrain, Brother Wilfredo, KSA, Sis Harriet, California. Amen. Welcome, Po. God bless you all. Amen. Let's greet each other with the welcome song, Hinai Matov.
Amen. Sa purihan ng Diyos sa gabing ito. Magkumustahan na po tayo mga kapatid at i-welcome po natin ang bawat isa nandoon yung pagmamahal at ang kagalakan. Amen. Purihan ng Diyos. Sa atin sa pagpupuri sa Kanya sa gabi ito. Amen! So handa na po bang bawat isa?
Amen!
Amen! Kunting mahina pa. Handa po ba ang bawat isa na magpuri sa atin nag-iisang Diyos?
Amen!
Amen! So puri na Diyos! Let God arise! Amen! Amen! So tunay nga ang ating Panginoon ay siyang dakila at napakabuti niya sa ating buhay. Amen! Dapat siya ipapurihan, dapat siya itaas, at dapat siya sambahin sa Espiritu at katotohanan. Amen. Come on, church!
Let God arise. praise the Lord and with you sing to your name, O God, Hosanna, to proclaim the love and faithfulness all the day and to the night.
La 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 la
la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la la in the house of Babylon, to live forevermore.
La la la,
la 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 like the trees of Lebanon, planted in the house of Babylon, there to live forevermore, there to live forevermore, there to live.
Where we long to be.
nothing compares to you, Jesus. Ikaw lamang ang nag-iisa. There is none like you. And tunay nga, Panginoon, napakabuti mo sa aming buhay. Salamat, Lord, sa iyong kadakilaan, sa iyong pagmamahal sa amin, na tunay nga, Lord, ay hindi nagmamaliw. At ikaw lamang ang Diyos na patuloy na nag-guide sa amin at nagligtas sa amin sa mga kasalanan. Maraming maraming salamat, Lord Jesus. Ang aming ginawa, Panginoon, ay hindi sapat upang pantayan, Panginoon, ang iyong ginawa sa aming buhay. Tunay nga, Lord, binuwas mo ang iyong buhay upang kami po ay maligtas. Salamat, Lord Jesus, sa iyong kabutihan. Ikaw lamang ang aming tinataas, Panginoon. Ikaw lamang ang aming sinasamba. Ikaw lamang ang aming pinapapurihan at pinapasalamatan. Ang iyong natatangi pangalan, Jesus Christ, ang makapangyarihang pangalan. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Amen. Palapakan natin muli ang ating Panginoong Diyos. Hallelujah.
Are you blessed, church? Jesus really loves us. There's a story of a pastor. A pastor, after every Sunday service in the afternoon, the pastor and his 11-year-old kid, they go out to distribute gospel tracts to all they meet in the streets. So one Sunday afternoon, it was chilly like how it is in Bahrain now. It was raining hard. So the 11-year-old kid, he packs himself with warm clothing and he says, "I'm ready, Dad. Let's go." Pastor asks, "For what?" "Let's go out and give the gospel tracts." Pastor said, "No, it's pretty cold outside. Let's leave it for this week." The kid wouldn't leave. He said, "Papa, can I go by myself?" Pastor said, "Okay, but be careful." So he thanked him, and the little kid, he went out and he started distributing the gospel tracts. After he has finished the entire bundle, he had one left. So that he was looking for somebody to give, there was nobody there. So he looks back, he sees a row of houses. He chooses the first home and he rings the bell. Nobody answers. He presses hard. Again, nobody answers. He keeps on pressing it for a long time. Nobody answers. He is about to leave, but something tells him no. He should stay and call upon the person inside. So he knocks the door. He thumps it hard, duck, 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 but nobody answers. Then he's about to leave. Then he turns back and he presses the bell. The door slightly opens and an old, sad-looking elderly woman, she comes out. The moment he sees her, he said, "Ma'am, I'm so sorry. I disturbed you. Jesus loves you. Please keep this gospel tract." The following Sunday, the pastor was in the pulpit and he called out, "Has anybody got any testimony to give or any message to share?" So from the back row, the elderly lady, she got up and she came walking slowly to the pulpit and she said, "I'm old. I lost my husband a few years ago. I have nothing to live, nothing to hold upon. There is no meaning in my life. There is no one to speak to me. So last Sunday afternoon, I went to my top attic of my house. I took a rope, I tied one end on the top and the other end I put around my neck and I wanted to end everything. Just then I heard a bell ring. I dismissed it thinking, there is no one who has rang the bell for so many years. So who is it going to be? So she dismissed the idea and she was going to go ahead to kill herself. But the sound wouldn't stop. It kept on thumping, thumping. So she took a moment and she came down. She opened the door. She saw one radiant looking boy with gleaming eyes and so much of hope. And he said, "Jesus loves you." And he said, "Jesus loves you." And she said, "The congregation, when I went to the attic and I saw the rope, I didn't have the reason for a rope anymore. Because I now know that," and she was not a Christian a week ago. So she realized how Jesus is so important and she started getting into the faith and she was so quite happy. So that is the story. So let us all get this belief that Jesus loves us. In fact, my life was so miserable about 6 months ago. Still Jesus loved me. With all the sins and all the bad things I did, I confessed. He loves me. He loved me and He brought me back to where I am today. I thank God for that. Today's ushering prayer will be Sister Chanda.
Magandang gabi po sa ating Panginoon at sa inyong mga kapatid. Makakatayo po muna tayo. Buksan po natin ang ating mga banal na aklat sa 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verses 6 to 7. 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verses 6 to 7. Ando na po ba ang bawat isa? Babasahin ko po muna sa English. Chapter 6. But this I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly. And he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Verse 7. Every man according as he purposeth in his heart, so let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. Sa Tagalog po, datapwat sinasabi ko, ang naghahasik ng bahagyana ay mag-aani namang bahagyana, at ang naghahasik na sagana ay mag-aani namang sagana. Verse 7, magbigay ang bawat isa ayon sa ipinasya ng kanyang puso, mabigat sa loob o dahil sa kailangan, sapagkat iniibig ng Diyos ang nagbibigay na masaya. Salamat po sa Panginoon sa kanyang pagkabasa, sa kanyang kabasa ng kanyang salita. Magsiupo muna tayo. Napakaganda po ng message sa gabing ito sa kanya, sa pagbibigay. Nawa po mga kapatid, sa pagbibigay po ay hindi po yung magbibigay lang po tayo dahil kailangan. O para makita ng ating mga kapatid na nagbibigay si ganito, ang laki ng binibigay niya. Pero meron tayong hindi po bukal sa ating loob. Kaya dapat magbigay po tayo na mayroong kagalakan sa ating mga puso dahil yun ay nakaka-lugod po sa ating Panginoon. Hindi po gusto ng Panginoon yung magbibigay ka dahil lang sa kailangan or kailangan na magbigay. Bagkus, palagi po nating isipin at isa pamuhay po na ang pagbibigay ay mayroong kagalakan sa puso. Dahil isipin po natin, no, sinave tayo ng Panginoon sa ating mga kasalanan. Yung pagbibigay po, kumbaga sa ating ikapiranggot lang to sa ginawa ng Panginoon sa buhay natin. So, kaya kailangan maging masaya po tayo at may kagalakan sa pagbibigay po sa Panginoon. Magsitayo po tayo at manalangin. Hallelujah Lord God Jesus. Panginoon, muli po, nagpapasalamat po kami sa buhay na ibinigay mo po sa aming lahat. Nawa Lord, convict mo po ang bawat isa na bibigay po at ibalik mo po sa kanila ng siksikliglig at umaapaw na pagpapala. Ikaw lang po ang aming pupurihin, sasambahin at dadakilain. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Well, I didn't understand the message. It's okay, all about offerings, so it is fine. God bless everybody. Today's special number will be given by Brother Larry.
Thank you. Thank you, Brother Raj. Thank you, Brother Buboy. Amen. So, it's a privilege po na makaawit sa harapan ng ating Panginoon. Ano po? Sa lahat po ng ito ay ang Diyos po dapat ating itaas. Amen. So, kung tayo po ay merong mga gift para sa pag-awit, huwag na po natin sayangin. Saka, makapagdating ng araw, hindi na po natin yan magamit. Amen. So, lahat po ng yan ay lilipas. Kung may pagkakataon po kayo ngayon, huwag nyo nang ipagpabukas pa. Amen. Praise God. So, samahan nyo po akong umawit dahil lang hininga ang siya pinaka-importante sa ating lahat. Pag wala na tayong hininga, without breath, hindi na po tayo mabubuhay, mga kapatid. Amen. Praise God. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your bread. This is my daily bread. Amen. Praise God. To God be all the glory.
It's okay. We are breathing in this life because of the mercy of the Lord. So with every breath, let us praise Him. Let us glorify His name. We are all guilty of something in our life that we might have done at some point or the other. And maybe we are living in self-pity. Let's see what the Lord has to say about it. Today's message will be delivered by Pastor Chris.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Are you blessed, church?
Amen.
Amen. May I request the congregation to please stand and let's open our Bible in the book of Psalms, chapter number 38, verse 4. Psalms, chapter number 38, verse 4. Amen. This message is for all of us. Are you ready?
Amen.
Amen. We're almost full. Amen. Amen. God is good.
Amen.
And all the time.
God is good.
Amen. In the book of Psalms, chapter number 38, verse 4, the Bible says, "My guilt has overwhelmed me like a burden too heavy to bear." Wow, we got very heavy. "My guilt has overwhelmed me like a burden too heavy to bear." Can you hear me? Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Can we lift our voices, church? Amen. Praise the Lord Jesus. Amen. Let's give Him a praise. Praise the Lord Jesus. Amen. Lord God Jesus. Thank you, Lord God Jesus. We worship you, Lord God. We magnify your name, O Lord God Jesus. Heavenly Father, Lord God Jesus, another privilege, another standing worship, Lord God Jesus, that we do believe that if two or three gathered together in your name, you are in our midst, O Lord God. Let your mighty angels guard over us, O Lord God Jesus, and your spirit, Lord, speak to us. Let your words, O Lord God Jesus, prick our hearts. And all the hearers of your word, O Lord God Jesus, will be transformed at the end of this message. We do believe, O Lord God Jesus, that your word is quick and powerful, and you will not allow us to leave this place, O Lord God, with empty-handed. We will declare your goodness, your mercies. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Just like what Brother Raj mentioned a while ago, we had a wonderful session in Jufair last night. Amen. And I do believe in Adlia and Ras Roman, you had fun also. Amen. And we're getting deeper and deeper in the Word of God. And a lot of people, you know, they don't have knowledge about God. And with this Bible study, it helped us to grow more. And God is giving us wisdom and understanding. Amen. So I'm encouraging you, brothers and sisters, to support ating mga Bible studies, especially Jufair. Jufair was designed for our foreign brethren. Amen. Foreign brethren. But if you speak in English, you are very much welcome. Amen. Just bring some tissues and... Oh, we have a medical kit there, Brother Raj, in case somebody will bleed their nose. Amen. Guilt. Guilty. Amen. Can you tell your neighbors, are you guilty? Guilt. most of us here experience guilt. Amen. We are not perfect. We're just human beings. But there are certain things that we feel this very emotional, ano po, should I say, part of our system, that sometimes if we commit some mistakes, we feel yung guilt and condemnation. Amen. And to dig more on about guilt, the Bible, or I mean the dictionary says, it is a cognitive, so it is intellectual. It is a cognitive or an emotional experience that occurs when a person believes or realizes accurately or not that he or she has compromised his or her own standards of conduct or has violated a moral standard and bears significant responsibility for that violation. It is closely related to the concept of remorse. Hello. May nakikinig. You can tell them to watch our live stream. Wala silang live stream. Amen. Praise God. Guilt. Amen. If you did something wrong and then you realize that you commit mistake, you feel this guilt. Amen. Amen. If you did it intentionally or unintentionally, sometimes you feel something that pushes you. Amen. Something that enable you, amen, to ask for forgiveness if you want to ask for forgiveness. Nevertheless, guilt in a sense that it's like a conscience. Binigyan tayo ng conscience ng Panginoon. You know what's conscience, Tina, right? Conscience, like if you did something and you feel bad about yourself, that, you know, like, oh, I should have not done these things, you know, like you hurt somebody and you feel something in your heart. Amen. Somehow, these guilty feelings help us to drive us to repentance. Amen. But there are certain people that they are very numb. They are so insensitive. Amen. In which, even though they hurt somebody, they don't want forgiveness. They don't have this guilt. Amen. They believe that they did what was right and they did not do anything wrong. And that's the problem. That's the problem. Amen. Like, if you're going to Singapore, okay, in Philippines, you can spit everywhere. You can spit everywhere. Sa? Right? Mawatan ti bagbaga kanya. I'm just speaking to my mic. Yun na lang mic yata nakikinig. Have you been in Singapore? You've been in Singapore? I haven't been in Singapore. But I read that if you spit in Singapore, you will go to hell. Go to jail. Shada naman. Oh, thank God. Still, you're awake. You're awake. Amen. See, in the Philippines, if they spit, it's normal. It's acceptable. Even making some, you know, toilet. Umihi. You're peeing. In some corners of the of our barangays, it's legalized, no? Basta pader, basta may pader. Any wall, dun tayo. Kung saan pa yung spot na bawal lang umihi dito, dun pa, right there and there. But in other countries, it's forbidden. Amen. And you spit in the Philippines, you don't have any conscience, you don't have any guilt, because everybody do it. Or does it. Right? But in Singapore, if you spit, you know, you might be cough, or even taking chewing gum. Chewing gum, it's forbidden. Even in the church here, it's forbidden, by the way. Huh? It's forbidden. Bakit? Kasi pag naglilinis kami, yung bubble gum nandiyan sa lalim ng ano niya, ng chair. So, guilt. Sino dito ang walang konsensya? Nobody will admit that I may consent. Amen. And that conscience and that guilty feeling will drive you to God. Amen. Amen. Because in the book of James, ang sabi sa book of James, that if you will not do the things that is right, it is a sin. Amen. And nobody knows about it. Nobody knows about it. For example, you saw a beggar begging for money or begging for bread. It's right to help them, you know? But you have this feeling na, hindi ko na kailangan tulong, laki-laki ng katawan. Ano po? Then you saw this person with disabilities. Amen. And then you just ignore him. And then at the back of your mind, you realize that, oh my God, sana tinulungan ko na lang. Diba? You have this guilty feeling, you know, like, it's normal to have a guilty feeling. But some people, they don't have. Some people, they considered correct what is legally called wrong. They don't mind. They don't care. What matters most is they are doing this. Kalas. I don't care if somebody will get hurt or somebody will not accept. But this is a democratic country. This is what I want to do. Amen. Yun po yung nakakatakot. Amen. Because in that sense, people will continue to commit sins. People will continue to do such things in which it is not accordance with the law of God. Amen. Because poor knowledge in the law of God, we spoke about law of God last night in Bible study, because I know that Brother Raj, imagine he was Hindu for almost, let's say, 50 years. And all of a sudden, God brought him here in this church. Amen. And he was transformed. He never heard about Jesus. Maybe he heard about Jesus, but he has no relationship with Jesus. You know, everybody knows Trump, right? Everybody knows Trump. All of us from, you know, Trump. Yung nagbebenta, yung, ano, Triumph yun, Triumph. Iba yung inisip, Trump. Trump, yung trumpeta. No, Trump. You know Trump, right? Everybody knows Trump all over the world. Even kids right now, they know Trump. He's the president of the United States of America. But the question is, kilala ka ba ni Trump? Do you know, I mean, tinanong mo, kilala ka ba ni Trump? No. It's the same. Most of us, we know God. We know God that is existing. The question is God knows you? So in order to know Him more, you have to build a relationship. Build a relationship. So you have to study His words. You have to dig and study the Word of God. Amen. So guilt, amen, is something like, it is an emotional and cognitive experience na kailangan po may embed ito sa ating mga puso. Because without guilt, you will not realize that you are committing mistakes. Amen. Amen. Okay. I want you to read the Bible. Amen. Let's open our Bible in the book of 2 Samuel. 11. 1 to 27. I know, mahaba po ito. But this is just a powerful story that I want you to know from today, and you will never forget this wonderful story. It's a lesson to learn. Amen. Hindi po ito babasahin natin, pagchichismisan natin si David. David is a man after God's own heart. David is a well-known, you know, David and Goliath. You know that he inspired a lot of musicians. Almost the book of Psalms, he wrote about the book of Psalms. Amen. He's one of the author of book of Psalms. He created an atmosphere wherein, you know, David and Goliath, yung concept ng David and Goliath, that this man of God, he represented a very simple man with a big God. Amen. Everybody knows David. Amen. Everybody knows David. When we were in grade 2 or grade 3, they taught us about David and Goliath. Amen. But the thing is, they always introduce David, amen, na bida, laging bida siya. But there are certain, part ng buhay ni David that is not very popular. Amen. He's a human being like us, but he was a man after God's own heart. How could it be? Is he perfect? Did he commit sin? Amen. Maybe some of us, this is the first time that you will encounter about David. You know David, right? Tina, first time you will encounter David and Goliath. Amen. Anyhow, this is a wonderful story. So I transfer the King James Version into NIV so that at least you will understand more. Okay, let's go. Okay. By the way, our worship service is up to 12 o'clock in the midnight. So please bear with us. Verse 1. In the spring. So spring is coming, right? A few months from now. Spring, at the time when kings go off to war, David sent Joab out with the king's men and the whole Israelite army. They destroyed the Ammonites and besieged Rabbah. But David remained in Jerusalem. That's the most important word. Amen. They have a battle. The kings of Israel. Okay? They have some wars going on. But King David, instead of going to the war, he prepared to stay in Jerusalem. Like what is going on right now. Live streamers, mga taga Bahrain. Malapit lang ang church. Amen. At imbes na pumunta ka sa church, instead of going to the church, nandiyan ka lang nanonood. Amen. Popcorn. Popcorn. Amen. So this is the problem. He's a king. He know that he has an obligation. He is responsible to be with the kings. Amen. But he prepared to stay home. Amen. Sino mga tamad dito magsabing amen? Pati magsalita, matamad. Like for example, alam mo na may gawain. Ayaw mo kasi tinatamad ka. Amen. Lalo na ngayon, right? 8 degrees, 9 degrees. Wow. This is not a bad weather. This is a bad weather. Amen. Mas prepare mo matulog. Amen. Now, what happened? In verse 2, one evening, David got up from his bed and walked around on the roof of the palace. Amen. Nobody was there. The kings are going for a war. But David, amen, wala siyang ginagawa. He walked around on the roof of the palace. From roof, he saw a woman bathing. Sino mahilig dito mamboso? He's a man of God, but when he saw a woman bathing, you know it is forbidden. Amen. We know that David is a man after God's own heart. We are expecting that when he saw that somebody is taking a bath naked, you will have your guilt feeling. He's married. May mga anak siya. But what happened, brothers and sisters? He stayed focused sa naliligo. See, hindi po ito dito kwentong barbero. This is true. Amen. I'm not talking about a classic magazine or any storytelling. This is true. The woman was very beautiful. Wow, imagine. The Bible, you know, exemplify that Bathsheba, she is so beautiful. Amen. And David sent someone to find out about her. That's another foul. Namboso ka na nga. Interesado ka pa. Amen. Where is your genuine guilty feelings? Sa inyong feel of yung konsensya mo, you are already married and then, yan, nagpa-part-time ka pa. Amen. Can I get a witness here? May asawa ka na nga, tinatagdagan mo pa. Only courageous people will say amen. 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 The man said, she is Bathsheba, the daughter of Eliam, and the wife of Uriah, the Hittite. Amen. Now, I think that's more than enough. Come on, David. Amen. You are crossing the line, right? You are crossing the line, David. Paraw nangingilabot, please. Amen. Don't do it. Amen. Don't do it. Maybe angels of God, they were gathered together and they're trying to pull out David. No, David, don't do that. She's already married. Come on, don't do that. What happened? Then David sent messengers to get her. She came to him and he slept with her. Alas. At hindi ko nadidetalya ano po kung ano nangyari. Maybe nag-jack and poi. Now, she was purifying herself from her monthly uncleanness. That means she's ovulating. Amen. Yung egg cell niya ay fertilized. Then she went back home. I couldn't imagine, you know, after the incident, maybe Bathsheba, she was crying. But she was helpless. He's a king. Ordered by the king. Amen. Ordered by the king. You cannot do anything about it. She was helpless. But David, where is his conscience? Yung guilt. He knew God. He was with God during the battle. Sa Valley of Elah. He knew that God is watching him. Amen. But where is the conscience, the guilt? Where is the Spirit of God on that time? Amen. Is it intentional? Judge it. I think it is intentional. He did it with a purpose. Okay na sana, nakilala niya. Oh, si Bathsheba, oh, taken na yan. Hey, taken na yan, sorry. Amen. But no, there are certain people until now sa church na ito. You know that he's a married man. She's married, but still pinipilit mo yung sarili mo. Where is your conscience? Where is your guilt? Amen. I'm not bashing here. I'm here to preach the gospel. Amen. Kung nasasaktan ka, it's up to you. Because the word of God is quick and powerful. But this is a lesson to learn. We are not reading this just to read and just to analyze the situation. We are learning from this mistake. Amen. So she went back. Now, the woman conceived. Imagine, nabuntis po siya and sent word to David saying, I am pregnant. I'm pregnant. David, King David, I'm pregnant. 2003, I receive ako. Doon, naikwento ko na sa inyo. Ting! Nasa ano kami? Sip wall. I was with you, I think. 2005. So, this is not 2003. I said, Jesus! Yeah, 2005. Somebody called me. Hello, Dr. Chris, kamusta po? I'm doing great. How are you, brother? I haven't seen you for quite some time. Yeah, Pastor, I want your help. Okay, sure. Pastor, you are the doctor, sabi niya. Nabuntis po yung girlfriend ko. My girlfriend, she got pregnant. I was about to tell, okay, mabruk, congrats. Okay, are you married? You can get married. Doctor, the problem is I have a family. Oh, that's a problem. That's a big problem. Pamilya siya. This is true, ha? Hindi po ito kwentong barbero. Kung gusto niyo yung detalye, mamaya. Okay, so, ano yung may tutulong ko sa'yo? What can I offer to you? He said, Doctor, since you are a doctor, are you doing abortion? Oh my goodness. Sabi ko, I think, wrong number. Hello. Wrong number. I studied medicine for 10 years, not to kill a person, but to give life. Amen. To extend life. Ito po yung ano natin, Hippocratic Oath. Amen. I think he called a wrong person. Amen. This is not... Thank God. David, when he heard that Bathsheba, she was pregnant. Amen. Hindi niya pinabort. Hindi niya pinabort. You know what he did? What he did? Oh my God, you made me laugh. So David sent word to Joab, send me Uriah the Hittite, yung asawa ni Bathsheba. And Joab, you know, maybe, what's wrong? And Joab sent him to David. When Uriah came to him, David asked him how Joab was, how the soldiers were, and how the war was going. Kinausap po niya ang asawa ng kanyang biktima. Then David said to Uriah, go down to your house and wash your feet. Meaning, umuwi ka sa bahay, magsiklib ka. Because Bathsheba is waiting for you. Okay? Why? To cover up. Kasi buntis eh. So, para sa ganun, kung magtatalik sila, absuelto ka.
Pero paglabas, kamukha mo. Kamukha ni pare. Hindi amen. Hindi amen. That's not right. Then David said to Uriah, go down to your house and wash your feet. So Uriah left the palace and gift from the king was sent after him. Binigyan pa siya ng gift. Amen. But Uriah, see, Uriah, instead of going home, you know what he did? Because he was a faithful soldier of David. Uriah slept at the entrance to the palace, hindi siya umuwi kay Bathsheba. Amen. With all his master servants and did not go down to this house. Imagine, Uriah! He was so faithful to David. Nakita niya, oh, walang tao dito. I have to be here. I have to protect my king because this is rightful. Amen. So the following day, David was told, Uriah did not go home. Muskil na yan. So nag-iisip na, di ba? Minsan, pag nagkakamali tayo, we are desperate people, we'll do desperate things. Amen. Iniisip mo na kung sino manghihilot, iniisip mo na kung kanin ka magpapa-abort because this is something, you know. I know some male here, until now, you are still hiding from your wife na meron kayong anak sa labas. Amen. Masakit. Haven't just come from a military campaign? Why didn't you go home? Uriah said to David, the ark and Israel and Judah are staying in tents, and my commander Joab and my lord's men are camped in the open country. How could I go to my house to hear and drink and make love to my wife? As surely as you live, I will not do such thing, my king. Imagine, ano po? You see, God is already talking to him. God is already knocking on your heart. Come on, you konsensya mo naman. Amen. You did it wrong. Huwag ka nang gagawa pa ng another step that it will regret. Yung decision mo. Amen. And this is an open mind, ano po? An open book para sa atin. Sometimes, because desperate situation, we are doing desperate things. Amen. When in fact, if you have the guilt and condemnation, stop na. Tama na yung isa. Minsan, tama na. Right? Yung pangalawa, pangatlo. Iba na yan. Sakit na yan. Nanood ka ng pelikula, Brother Ricky. Ah. Kasama mo, dapat kasama mo sa sine ang sawa mo. Pag may kasama ka sa ngayon pa, matatanggal. Amen. Pag nanonood kayo ng sine, pag may asawa, huwag kayong manonood ng sine, may asawa. That's forbidden. Pag minsan nawawala yung common sense, no? Pulutin mo nga yung common sense mo. Ang masakit pa, nabidyoan ka pa. Yun, wala kang kawala. Kaya pag mag-iaya kayo, yung mga single na lang. Single. Amen. Ba't tayo napunta dyan? Then David said to him, stay here one more day and tomorrow I will send you back. So Uriah remained in Jerusalem that day and the next. He never go home, amen, to meet her wife because he was a dedicated, he was so faithful to David, amen. Instead of going home, he decided to be in the gate and protecting the king, amen. So what's the next action? What's the next action? At David's invitation, he ate and drank with him. Nilasing pa niya. Ang tindi ni David. Ano po? David, sorry. This is just, magmimitarin tayo sa langit. I'm not bringing it down, David, but this is what happened. And David made him drunk. Intentionally. But in the evening, Uriah went out to sleep on his mat among his master's servants. He did not go home. He did not go home. See? My God. Sana makita pa kayo ng Uriah, no? Faithful husband. Uriah that is faithful. Amen. Verse 14, in the morning, David wrote a letter to Joab, tama na, and sent it with Uriah. Ano sabi niya? In it, he wrote, pwede kang umupo, kapatid, magkakaroon ka ng barang kusbain. Put Uriah out in front where the fighting spears. Imagine, ngayon, kanina, palasing-lasing lang niya. Now, he wanted Uriah to lead the troops. And then, pag nag-lead niya yung troop, magbaback out ang mga Israel so that Uriah will be killed. See? Nagsimula lang yan saan? Sa pomboboso. Nagsimula lang yan sa pasilip-silip. Nagsimula lang yan, nanonood ka ng pornography na hindi mo kasama ang asawa mo. And then natitempt ka. May nakikita kang ibang damit. Then you started playing around. Yun na. Saan nagsimula yan? Sa pamboboso. Panunood ng pornography. And we have some studies. We have some studies that most of the adulterer, they started watching pornography. Amen. Some of them, they admit, but some of them, they did not. Amen. Put Uriah out in front where the fighting is fiercest. Then withdraw from him so he will be struck down and die. So while Joab had the city under siege, he put Uriah at a place where he knew the strongest defenders were. Imagine Uriah, walang kamalay-malay. He was so faithful. We need some Uriah in the palace. But what happened? They play games. They put him in the top and then they back out. Anong nangyari, brothers and sisters? In verse 17, when the men of the city came out and fought against Joab, some of the men in David's army fell. Moreover, Uriah the Hittite died. So you win the battle, David? You won? Nasaan yung guilt? Nasaan po yung conscience? You did it with a purpose. This is a master plan. Amen. Nakakalungkot na po. Do you think this scenario is not happening today? It is. The same spirit that destroying family is still active until now. Joab sent David a full account of the battle. He instructed the messenger, when you have finished giving the king this account of the battle. In verse 20, the king's anger may flare up, and he may ask you, why did you get so close to the city to fight? Didn't you know that they would shoot arrows from the wall? Who killed Abimelech, son of Jerubbaal? Didn't a woman drop an upper milestone on him from the wall so that he died in Thebes? Why did you get so close to the wall? If asked you this, they say to him, wherever your servant Uriah the Hittite is dead. This is only what need to hear. Right? Nakakalungkot, ano po? Ba't kayo malungkot? Masaya tayo. The messenger sent out, and when he arrived, he told David everything Joab had sent him to say. The messenger said to David, the man overpowered us and came out against us in the open, but we drove them back to the entrance to the city gate. Actually, this is the instruction. This is the master plan. Then the archers shot arrows at your servants from the wall, and some of the king's men died. Moreover, your servant Uriah the Hittite is dead. This is what you want, right? This is the desire of your heart. Amen. So be it. So be it. Amen. Nakakalungkot na po. Okay. David told the messenger, say this to Joab, don't let this upset you. The sword devours one as well as one as another. Press the attack against the city or destroy it. Say this, encouraged Joab. When Uriah's wife heard that her husband was dead, she mourned for him. Umiyak po. Of course, asawa na yun. After the time of mourning was over, David had her brought her to his house, and she became his wife and bore him a son. But the thing David had done displeased the Lord. Displeased the Lord. Amen. God is not happy. You know what happened? If you will read the succeeding verses, the child was born and he died. And he died. And that's the consequences ano po, ng kasalanan ni gawa ni David. Still, David, because this is his master plan, the Bible did not mention about guilt and condemnation. He kept it in his heart with Joab. Yun po yung master plan nila. Amen. Can we ask David if he is still able to sleep at night? Nakakatulog pa ba siya ng mahimbing? Yes, you have what you want, but what happened? Brothers and sisters, sinira mo yung pamilya ni Bathsheba. Are you happy with that? Are you happy with that? Can you sleep at night destroying another family? This is just a wake-up call for us, brothers and sisters. Before entering a relationship, make sure yung relationship na yan ay may happy ending. But I doubt. I haven't seen na nagsasama kayo, hindi mag-asawa, nagkaroon kayo ng happy ending. I doubt. It's not. Because the most important thing is you have to be blessed by God. Amen. Patago-tago. We have only one life. Come on, church. Ladies and gentlemen, we have only one life in this earth. Amen. Well, we failed. Noon, sayang ano? Sayang. Ngayon lang tayo nagkatagpo. Ayok sabihin sa wasa ko eh, dahil I finally found the love of a lifestyle. Pinapasaya ko lang kayo, masyado kayong seryoso eh. Amen. Now, what happened? Ito na po yung ating message for today. Amen. God is not dead. Amen. Sabihin mo nga sa atin mo, God knows what you did. Meron bang kirot? Nung sinabi ng katabi mo, God saw what you did, may kirot ba? Come on, sino may kirot? May kirot? May kirot? May kirot? Sister Mai, hindi ko alam kung ano yung kirot sa English. Chinese muna. I don't know what is kirot. What? No, pain. Pain is pain. Kirot, iba yung kirot eh. Touch? No. Ha? Google mo nga. Okay. Ha? Hurt? Okay. Because God saw what you did. Amen. Pwede mong itago yan sa asawa mo for how many years. You can keep the secret for how many years. Amen. But God will expose it one day. One day. One day. One day. Mabubulaga ka na lang. May kumakatok sa inyo. Sino ka? Where is my daddy? Kaya kung ako sa inyo ngayon pala, mag-confess na kayo. Mag-confess na kayo. May kinakausap ako dito. Hello, Mike. Brother Mike. Are you ready, church?
Yes.
Now, babasahin ko na lang po because I know you're getting bored. Amen. Let's open our Bible in the book of Psalms. Oh, I mean, in 2 Samuel 12, verse 1 to 3, 13. Now, makinig lang po kayo. Makinig lang kayo. Now, the Lord sent Nathan to David. Prophet Nathan, pinadala po ng Panginoon kay David. When he came to him, he said, makinig kayo, there were two men in a certain town, one rich and the other poor. The rich man had a very large number of sheep and cattle, but the poor man had nothing except one little old lamb he had bought. He raised it and he grew up with him and his children. It shared his food, drank from his cup, and even slept in his arms. It was like a daughter to him. Verse 4, now a traveler came to the rich man, but the rich man refrained from taking one of his own sheep or cattle to prepare a meal for the traveler who had come to him. Instead, he took the ewe lamb that belonged to the poor man and prepared it for the one who had come to him. David burned with anger against the man and said to Nathan, as sure as the Lord lives, the man who did this must die. He must pay for the lamb four times over because he did such a thing and had no pity. Diba? Nakikinig lang po siya. Nakikinig siya. But his conscience is guilt. Amen. He condemned this guy, yung rich man na gumawa nun. And you know what happened? Verse 7, then Nathan said to David, you are the man. You are the man. This is what the Lord God of Israel says. I anointed you king over Israel, and I delivered you from the hand of Saul. I gave you master's house to you, and your master's wives into your arms. I gave you all Israel and Judah. And if all this had been too little, I would have given you even more. Why did you despise the word of the Lord by doing what is evil in his eyes? You struck down Uriah the Hittite with the sword and took his wife to be your own. You killed him with the sword of the Ammonites. Now therefore the sword will never depart from your house because you despised me and took the wife of Uriah the Hittite to be your own. Ang sakit, ano? You know, yung covenant na mag-asawa, God is watching over you. The moment that God bless you, God is watching over you. Amen. Kaya nga kapag may third party na pumasok, you better watch out. You better not cry.
Because ang sabi ng Panginoon, vengeance is mine, said the Lord. Pag sinira mo yung relasyon ng mag-asawa, pumasok ka doon sa gitna, third party ka, you will be in trouble. God is watching. Sinabi ng Panginoon, si Bathsheba at si Uriah, the Hittite, very specific. Very specific, ganun ng Panginoon. Very specific, binabantayan po niya tayo. Amen. Ayan po ba? Wala na yata akong kausap eh. Why did you despise the word of the Lord by doing what is evil in his eyes? You struck down Uriah the Hittite with a sword and took his wife to be your own. You killed him with the sword of the Ammonites. Now therefore the sword will never depart from your house because you despised me and took the wife of Uriah the Hittite to be your own. This is what the Lord says. Out of your own household, I am going to bring calamity on you. Before your eyes, I will take your wives and give them to one who is close to you. And you will sleep with your wives in broad daylight. You did it in secret. I will do this thing in broad daylight before all Israel. See? Ang sabi niyo, God is love. Ang Panginoon po, pag nagalit, masakit. Amen. And you know, at this point, after all the scenario, after all the incidents, after all the dramas, ano po, what happened in verse 13? In verse 13, then David said to Nathan, I have sinned against the Lord. You know what happened? The Lord God of Israel, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, he was about to kill David. But, makinig kayo, when he heard the word of God, amen, from his ears, went to his brain, and his brain digested the word of God, and those particles, word of God, went over to his heart, and the heart changed the mind of David. Anong sinabi niya? No! It's Bathsheba's fault! Alam naman niya may banyo, ba't pa siya sa labas naliligo? You can do excuses. You can blame others. You can blame others. Bakit kasi si Uriah, iniwan niya yung asawa. You can blame. But what we see in this scenario, David, when he heard the word of God, he said, I have sinned against the Lord. This is the secret word that came from David. And you know what happened? He was about to kill David. Amen. But what happened when he confessed? When he confessed that he sinned against the Lord, everything changed. In a blinking of an eye, God changed his plan. You know why? Because if David will be killed on that time, there will be no Messiah. Walang Jesus. Why? Because Jesus Christ came from the root of David. So kung mamamatay po si David, walang Messiah na darating in the next future. So what happened? Satan, he was rejoicing because ito yung master plan ni Satan, right? Ito yung gusto ni Satan to kill, to steal, and to destroy. Amen. But what happened when he confesses sin? Palagay ko po, nag-myocardial infarction si Satan, no? Nabulaga. Ganun pala ang Diyos. Yes, ganun ang Diyos. God is so good. God is so merciful. God can forgive us even though tayo po ay maraming millions na ating mga kasalanan. If you confess, He is faithful and just to forgive our sins. Amen. Once nandun na po yung guilt sa ating mga puso, once guilt entered into your heart, amen, and you realize that you commit sin, not only sa iyong kapwa, even sa God na ating pong sinasamba, eventually God can transform ang lahat po ng buhay mo. Maybe now you are in the last rope ng buhay mo, brothers and sisters, but I'm telling you, God can transform yung buhay mo, amen, if you just confess and accept the fact that you sin against the Lord. Amen. Amen po ba? Kaya huwag kayong uuwi na may mga guilt and condemnation mamaya because David described his feeling this way in Psalms 32 verse 3 to 4. When I kept silent after the incident, ha? Tingnan natin. Makinig kayo. When I kept silent, my bones wasted away through my groaning all day long. For day and night, your hand was heavy upon me. My strength was sapped in the heat of summer. See what happened, brothers and sisters? From the experience of David, amen, he was already having these thoughts. Nung ginawa niya po yan, walang nakakaalam, but sa kanyang puso, David's guilt made him suffer physically. Physically. Tingnan po natin. Those who are committing mistakes, those who are intentionally commit mistakes, they are prone to sicknesses. They are prone to sicknesses. Tumataas ang presyon, their blood pressure is rising, their sugar is rising, all tumataas. Hindi lang yung sahod. He said his bones were wasting away like there was a heavy weight upon him, right? Kapag nandun na yung, di po ba? Pag nandun na yung guilt, hindi ka na nakakatulog eh. Nakukonsensya ka na eh. No? Your conscience is there. You know, you open your Facebook and those poor children who are longing for their dad, sinaktan mo sila. You did not even think about their future. You're only thinking about yourself. At nakikita mo sa Facebook yung mga anak ng biktima mo. This is what's going on right now. My goodness, how many times you attending this church? Almost Monday hanggang Sunday nandito ka, and yet wala pa rin yung convictions, wala pa rin yung conscience, wala pa rin yung guilt feeling. Para stop na natin yung mga foolish things na ito. See, but I know your bones were wasting away like there was a heavy weight upon him, like his strength was totally gone. But why would David feel like that? Because of guilt. Because of guilt. Amen. And why would we feel like that? Nararamdaman mo ba yan? Sleepless nights? Nakikinig ka? Nanunod ka sa live stream right now? Nagkakaroon ko ng mga sleepless nights? Maybe you did something wrong. Kaya ngayon, nabababagabag ang konsensya mo. Ganun. Ha? Okay, basta may bag, okay na yun. Amen. You cannot try to cover your sins and expect to solve your problem. Amen. I'm talking to you right now. You cannot hide. You can run, but you cannot hide. Amen. So, what you gonna do? Anong dapat nang gagawin? How can you get rid of the guilt? Amen. Huh? Brother Max? How can we get rid of the guilt? Well, you confess to God. Confess it to God. Kung hanggang ngayon po, meron kayong guilty feelings. I used to ask, ano po, especially those who are new in the church. Sometimes I'm asking about your situation. But sometimes, you lie. Amen. You lie. Doon nagkakaroon ng problema. Once hindi ka nagiging totoo sa sarili mo, you will never be set free. How can you get rid of the guilt? Confess it to God. In Proverbs 28:13, the Bible says, tell us, whoever conceals his transgressions, kung sino man nagtatago ng kanyang kabulukan, will not prosper. Amen. Kaya hindi ka pinagpapala ng Panginoon because until now, you are concealing something else sa buhay mo. Amen. And this is the most dangerous part of this message. He who confesses and forsakes them will obtain mercy. Will obtain mercy. Amen. I'm not here na-expose yung mga guilt and condemnation na nararamdaman nyo. I know most of us were was away doon sa baptism fall. Amen. But again, don't go back sa mga kasalanan na yan. It's not healthy for us, brothers and sisters. Whoever conceals his transgressions will not prosper. Sabi mo sa katabi mo yan, lagot ka. Bakit? If you conceal your sins and transgression, hindi ka pagpapalay ng Panginoon. Try it. Just be honest. Be honest, brothers and sisters. God, mahal ng Panginoon ang mga honest hearts. Right? Just try to think of it. If you are honest enough, God will give you increase. God will prosper you. Amen. Sino dito yung hindi po napopromote hanggang ngayon? Hanggang ngayon hindi kayo napopromote? Come on. Okay. Amen. Yan, Sister Berno, sinintay kita. Maybe this is the problem, brothers and sisters. Baka may kinukonsil kayo. Transgressions. That's why God is not giving you prosperity. Amen. Kasi kapag ipaprosper ka ng Panginoon, baka dadagdagan mo yung pamilya mo. Because God knows the future. Right, Brother Ricky? God knows the future. Amen. If may increase ka, baka dadagdagan mo yung asawa. Hindi ka bibigyan ng Panginoon. Amen. But if your intention is right, God will prosper you. God will prosper you. Amen. And David learned the same truth. In Psalms 32 verse 5, I acknowledge my sin to you. And I did it, not cover my iniquity. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the iniquity of my sin. Amen. Are you ready to give everything to God? Amen. Amen. Sino po ditong may sikretong malupit? Pag nagtas kayo ng kamay, hindi na siya secret. Hanggang ngayon, hindi alam ng asawa mo. Wala, no? Wala nga amin. Lalo na naka-livestream, naka-record yan. See this man. See the face of this man. Have you ever have this posture in your life that you mess something, that you just put your hand in front of your face? I messed. I have this guilty feeling. Amen. Nagkaroon po tayong ganyan na experience. Come on, church. Thank you. Honest hearts. Yeah. Parang, I did it my way. Did you Google it, Brother Raj? Frank Sinatra? No. Sister Tina, I think. She knows that song, right? Because you know the song, Lonely, Mr. Lonely. So I'm expecting you to learn also. You can Google it, I Did It My Way by Frank Sinatra. Amen. During this Sister Ida's time. Amen. Lastly, there was an interesting study done last year by researchers in the United States and in Israel. The study involved over 4,000 test subjects confess things they think felt guilty and ashamed. Researchers found that those who only confessed part of what they've done wrong felt worse than those who made a full confession of their guilt. I think hindi na natin kailangan ni research ito, no? Common sense na lang. No? Now, the Harvard Business Review summarized the research this way. Confession is a powerful way to relieve guilt, but it works only if you tell the whole truth, but nothing but the truth. So help me God. Amen. I think it helps. Kailangan po natin expose. Amen. Sabihin natin lahat. Amen. Sabihin natin lahat. And I'm experiencing it for the past few days. This afternoon, I have 27-year-old guy who was complaining of difficulty of urination. He was very large. Doctor, I have a problem. What's your problem, dear? I have difficulty of burning sensation. Okay, since you are consulted, consulting me, can I ask you one thing? Are you single? Yun ang una-una kasi ko. Yes, doctor. Have you been in Gudaibiya? No, doctor. Jufer! I'm not bashing you. No, doctor. Isip Pilipina. Pag isa lang isip natin, ha? Hindi pa kinukwento sa ito. Isip Pilipina. No, doctor. Thailandia. No, doctor. Okay, I have to be honest, doctor. Hindi. Para tayong chismosa. In short, what did you do last night? No, it's been 2 days, doctor. So, you know, I cannot treat you if you will not be honest. Okay? I will do some tests. Sabi sa kanya, I will do some tests. In-examine ko siya. Nako, problema. Mukhang gonorrhea. So I told him, okay, go to Sister Ann's lab and then give a sample of urine. Positive. Ano po? Positive. See, what if you make another story? Huh? Just simple UTI. But I can see in space, sino nagkaroon ng tulo dito? Tulo. Sino nagkaroon ng tulo? Mga lalaki. Thank you. Oy, salamat sa kamay mo. Siyempre, walang aamin. Yeah, man, it's may dribbling sensation. Ang hirap, ah. Yun talaga tumatalon. Dribbling sensation, eh. So, dribbling. Ang sakit. Hindi na makayanan itong taong itong batang ito. So, it's the same. Once you want to be cured, to be treated by God, confess everything to God. If you want to be set free, tell everything. Para magkaroon kayo ng wonderful relationship between you and your wife, brothers and sisters, be honest with them. Be honest. This is the secret. Amen. Para magkaroon ng trust ang asawa mo. Amen. It's the same. Once you want to be set free from any guilt and condemnation, be honest sa ating Panginoon. Amen. Accept. You cannot pull yourself from darkness into His marvelous light. Nobody can do that. Only God can do that. Amen. So if you want to be rescued by God, sabi mo, Lord, I need you. Lord, I need you. Amen. Lagi natin na example yan, di ba, Brother Gary? Kayong mga FA, di ba? Nag-swimming kayo. Amen. Nag-swimming kayo, anong pangalan ng mga nagsisafeguard? Lifesaver. Amen. Lifeguard. If somebody's drowning, Sister Tina, amen, and they are uncontrolled, you know, they are struggling, nobody can help you. Nobody can help you. Amen. But if you will give yourself your hand, amen, you surrender everything, and then that's the time that they can rescue you in a single minute. Don't struggle in this life. You need God. We need God. I need God. You need God. We need God. Amen. So that in order to be relieved, ano po, sa guilt and condemnation, please, maging honest po tayo. Lalabas man tayo ngayon, brothers and sisters, God will set us free. And this is about the duck. Right? Do you still remember the duck? Yung kwento ng duck? Kayo na nga magkwento? Nakalimutan ko na yan. You know that duck, Sister Gina? Yung duck? Hindi. May dalawang magkapatid. There were two brothers and sisters. Amen. And they have grandmother. Grandmother. Inantok na kayo? Pagbigyan niyo na ako. 4 minutes na lang. 4 minutes. Two brothers and sisters. And they have grandmother. The grandmother, meron siyang duck. Special duck. Pecking duck. Pecking duck. You know pecking duck? Pecking duck. Peck duck. Pecking. Pecking in China, no? Pecking duck. Do you eat duck? Duck. Duck. Paano yung sound ng back? Quack, 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 quack. Hindi, quack, quack. Albulari yun. Eh. Brother, quack, quack yun. Quack, quack. Okay, two siblings with grandmother made duck. So while these two kids, they were playing in the garden with a slingshot, the brother accidentally hit the duck, and the duck died. And the sister witnessed the incident. Oh my God. Lovely duck was killed by his brother. So what happened? They hide. Ano po? They buried 6 feet under. No, yung duck. 6 feet under. No traces of anything. No traces of anything that the duck. Ano po? Maybe the grandmother maybe thought it just flew away or naghanap siya ng ibang boss, ibang grandmother. So one time, the grandmother called the two siblings. And then, sabi niya, yung babae, sabi natin, pangalan niya is Linda. Linda, what's the disease, my dear? Okay, what's the disease? And Linda, you know, the sister, he called the brother. Brother, come here. What's the disease? What? I'm a... Remember the duck. Okay. See? Because of the duck, it was doing these things, these toys. The blackmail. And the sister was so happy. You know? Because yung stronghold ng kapatid, very strong. And the grandmother told him, oh, bili nga kayo na suka. Linda, buy some vinegar. Kuya, what the... Remember the duck. Every day and every night. Every day and every night. Okay? Paglilinis ng banyo. Siya nang... See, imagine. Yun yung pinaka-hardest part ng buhay. Amen. Right? It came to a point that 1 year na. Always insisted, Kuya, yung duck. It was always reminding her the duck. Kaya duck ng duck. Nakuha yun sa duck. Kalas is fed up. The boy approached the grandmother. Grandmother, I have something to tell you. It's been one year. I killed your duck. I confess. Not killed the duck. I'm sick and tired of being slaves. And the grandmother smiled. I know. I saw you killed the duck. Bakit ka nagtagal na for 1 year? You hide this. You did not even mention it. You did not confess it. If you confess from that very moment, you are freed. Kaya yung sister, kuya, daktakin kita. Amen. Tayo po'y tumayo. Amen. Confession will unlock the door. If you are still struggling right now, you are under control. You know, in the book of Revelation, it mentioned that Satan is always going to heaven day and night. Sinusumbong tayo sa Panginoon. You know that? Satan is the accuser of our brethren. Satan is always telling God, ah, so dangerous! Nandun siya sa ura! Ah, I saw Brother Archie! May kasama! Amen. To reverse everything, confess. Pag nakagawa po tayo ng kasalanan, we are prone to sin, to commit mistakes, but the moment that yung sin will enter into your heart, mag-release ka na. Stay away. The Bible says, resist the devil and he will flee from you. He will flee from you. And if you're still playing around with devil and he's always accusing you, brothers and sisters, stop. Confess to God. Lord, I commit sin. I commit sin. How many of you right now struggle? Because yung mga ginawa natin po, what you are doing right now, it will affect your tomorrow. Hindi po nangangulugan na naglaro ka ngayon, gumawa ka ng kasalanan, absuelto ka bukas. See, in every, sabi nga ni Sister Chanda kanina, kung ano yung tinanim mo, yan ang anin mo. Kung nagtanim ka ng anumang pong bagay na hindi accordance sa kalooban ng Panginoon, it's like wages. You're working on it. And the Bible speaks to it. Wages of sin is that. Yeah, don't play around. Come on, church. Pag nandun na yung guilt, yung conscience mo, just look at the mirror. Tignan mo yung sarili mo. What? I am doing these things. This is not right.
Bakit ko ginagawa to? Bakit ako pumapasok sa relasyon na hindi dapat? I have to stop myself. Because nobody can help you but yourself, kapatid. Amen. Kaya stop struggling. Kung ngayon nag-struggle ka pa rin, it's time for you to be set free. It's a matter of saying, Lord, I have sinned against Thee. Wala akong may pagmamalaki sa iyo, Lord God Jesus. I want to stop this thing. It's not healthy, Lord. I'm destroying other family, Lord. I'm destroying other family. Yung future ng mga anak nitong nung pinapatulang ko, Lord. Kaya, Lord God, give me wisdom. You know what? God will give you wisdom if you will ask Him, brothers and sisters. Amen. So stop making excuses. Don't blame. Huwag mong blame yung asawa mo. Hindi kasi naliligo. Pastor, yung asawa ko, naghanap ako pa. Come on. May time din na hindi maliligo yan. And again, babalik at babalik ka. From A. Tandaan mo, anything that you leave, pagbalik mo, baka wala na. Wala na. As the prodigal son, he has everything what he needs, but he left. He left. Wala siyang konsensya. He left his father. And then along the way, anong nangyari? Doon na. He realized na, ang sarap palang mabuhay sa aking ama. Nandun na. Yung genuine, nandun na yung genuine na guilt sa feeling mo, and then you want to get back. Ano sabi niya? Gusto ko bumalik sa aking ama, hindi na ako tatawagan na anak, kahit na ano na lang ako, alila na lang. See, it's time for us to come back, mo church. God is waiting for us. How many months, how many years? God is waiting for us. He's waiting for us, and He's willing to forgive us. He's faithful and just to forgive us. If you want to be set free right now, it's up to you. Kung gusto mong pagbuklat ng mata mo bukas, it's the same problem that you're facing. It's your decision. But if I'm telling you, tutukan na natin ngayon. Tutukan na natin ngayon. If you're doing not right, tutukan mo na ngayon, brothers and sisters. Do not allow yourselves na uwi na ganun pa rin po pagkagising mo. God is so good. And this message, hindi po ito para gawin natin ulit. No, it's not. It's a lesson to learn. Amen. You know the consequences. Marami po nangyari sa buhay ni David na dapat hindi nangyari. But because of lack of insensitivity, kaya po nagagulo-gulo ang buhay niya. Amen. Let's bow our heads. Pray. Heavenly Father, Lord God Jesus, thank you, Father God, for the convictions of your Holy Spirit. Sabi nga po ni Haring David, cast me not away from thy presence, O Lord, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and create in me clean heart. Heavenly Father, Lord God Jesus, I know a lot of people, a lot of brethren, even our live stream viewers right now, they are struggling sa mga nangyayari sa kanilang buhay. And if you are still concealed yung mga transgressions, you will never prosper us. Lord God, you know mga honest hearts right now in this congregation. Lord God, reveal to them, reveal to us, O Lord God Jesus, your words. Convict us, O Lord God Jesus. If we're not doing the right thing, O Lord God Jesus, Lord God Jesus, gisingin mo po kami. Gisingin mo ang mga natutulog, Panginoon, Lord God Jesus. And remind them, O Lord God Jesus, dapat po hindi na kami nabubuhay sa guilt and condemnation because we already wash away the sins during the baptism in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord God Jesus, ikaw po ang mauna at maghari sa amin, Panginoon. Lord God Jesus, thank you for this wonderful moment. Thank you, Father God, Lord, for bringing us here again. And hopefully, O Lord God Jesus, we will meet the same faces, O Lord God. We will meet the same brethren. Maging aming mga visitors, O Lord God Jesus. They will give you another chance to attend next week. Lord, next week and next week, next week, next week, O Lord God Jesus. And convict us, Father God, Lord, sa aming mga nagawang pagkakasala sa inyo. Thank you, Father God, Lord Jesus, sa lahat po ng aming mga kapatid, even sa live stream, Lord, ng aming mga kapatid sa California, sa Oman,
sa Saudi Arabia, sa Philippines, even dito sa Bahrain, O Lord, even sa Ireland, O Lord God Jesus, they are watching right now. Bless them mightily, O Lord God Jesus. Lord, thank you, Father God, sa gabing ito, full of wisdom and knowledge. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. God bless you, church.